Well, good morning. My name's Mr. Mitzel. Say hi, Mr. Mitzel.
Hi, Mr. Mitzel. Okay.
And I have a really cool job. I do math all day long. How many people want that job? A lot of you want that job. Read Two Ways is a strategy designed for reading comprehension for students to ground them in the context of a problem. You guys ready to do some math?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. So what it looked like today with the fifth grade students I was working with. The first read, we did a strategy of an echo read where I would read the sentence and they would read it back to me. It says, at open bowling night, it costs $2 with a membership card and $4 without a card. You guys go.
At open bowling night, it costs $2 with a membership card and $4 without a card.
And then I gave them a chance to have a partner talk where they were not allowed to use any numbers or operations.
But John doesn't have it, so it's gonna cost more for John and his friends. But he has like some of his friends.
And then we pull them out and we have them do a whole class discussion about some of the observations they have about the problem. How many people have at least one idea about this problem without numbers or operations?
Said that John had that. John didn't have a card.
Pause! How many people agree with that? The reason we do not allow the students to use the numbers is we truly want them to start to understand the context of the problem. Many times students really struggle with not having the ability to just go automatically to the numbers. We used a silent read for the second read, and then again allowed the students to have a partner talk. And here's some great news. You're gonna actually get to use numbers this time, but this time there's still no operations. But you are gonna get to use numbers, okay? In the second read, the goal is not for them now to take the quantities that are in the problem and have a discussion around those quantities and what those quantities mean within the context of the problem.
Me and Tim were thinking, the one is John, but the two, where'd you get the two?
When we use the strategy of Read Two Ways, a major component that we also embed is the idea of student discourse.
So I think the answer is reasonable.
When students are allowed the ability to discuss their ideas with one another, what begins to surface is they have a deeper understanding of the mathematics that are embedded in the context of the problem. And you'll see the rich conversations that take place when they're creating a viable argument based on the mathematics that they're doing at that time. And so without student discourse, many times students, they just do not have that opportunity to revise their thinking.
That would make it 6 + 6 = 12.
Many times students struggle with entry points into a problem, and many times they get stuck and they give up. So we're targeting that idea of perseverance as well as sense making.
It says John and five friends are going to open bowling night, which means that there's six people.
How many people agree to that?
Many of them are very answer oriented. They want to automatically jump to a solution path. And using this strategy allows them to truly look at the context of the problem and not allowing the automatic solution pathway. Read Two Ways really is a way to enable students to strictly look at the context of a problem, and then they have a much greater access to the problem, and therefore their perseverance level increases drastically. I want you to raise your hand really high, way up in the air like this. Either hand, raise your hand, come on, really high, up in the air, up in the air. Raise your hand really high, really high, really high. You ready? And now you're gonna pat yourself on the back. You guys did a wonderful job today. It was so much fun allowing me to come in and do some math with you today.